long morning. I've already been out. You can see my hair is really, really curly. I had to be at an appointment around 6 o'clock this morning. And then by the time I came out of the building, it was snowing so much that I had to clean off all the snow off the car. And, you know, my curly hair is even curlier today. And actually, I got up at 4 o'clock. So I hope I remember what I'm doing today. Anyway, what we're going to do is we're going to do a Manhattan clam chowder today. It's one of my favorites, and it's one of those soups that you can make a whole lot of. I usually like triple the recipe, and of course, as you know, I always give it most of it away, but it's nice to have in the freezer. It's also one of those recipes where you could do just the put all the ingredients in the pot the night before. And then when you get home from work or from wherever your busy day might be, you know, just put it on the stove because it takes about an hour to cook. And then we're going to do a very light avocado salad. So let's get started. In my pan here today, I have about 3 tablespoons of butter, of which we want to melt. So going pretty slow. I don't know when I'm ever going to get it through my head to turn this burner on before I turn the video camera on, but eventually I will. This is no big production that I do here. So anyway, so it's melting. As soon as it melts, we'll start and I'll show you. What we'll do though in the meantime is maybe we'll get our dressing ready for our avocado salad. It's very, very simple. First, we're going to put in the juice, got the wrong knife here, the juice of half a lime. We'll put that in. And get this going here. There we go, we got the juice of a half a lime. Ooh, some lime smells good. Always smells good. So we've got the juice of a half a lime. And then I'm going to put in a tablespoon of a nice balsamic vinegar. I like good vinegars. I have a lot of flavored ones too. In fact, one of these days I'll use some of them and kind of show you the different things that you can do with some flavored vinegars. I have pistachio vinegar, I have chocolate vinegar, I have raspberry vinegar. I got all kinds of vinegar. Anyway, so we'll do that with the vinegar, and then we're going to put in some walnut oil. Walnut oil is really good. It's not hard to find either. If you can't get it at one of your bigger local grocery stores, you can always go to, you know, like a Better Health or those type of stores, and you can find the walnut oil. So come on, butter, get going a little faster. So anyway, I'm going to put in a half a cup of walnut oil into our vinegar and lime juice. You know, if you ever make a salad with beets, the walnut oil is excellent to use in a salad like that. So anyway, all I'm doing is mixing this up, adding the oil to the vinegar and lime juice. And that's it. That's our dressing for our avocado salad. Get that going. Mix it till it's, you know, all together. Move some of this stuff out of the way. We'll put our lid back on here. Whoa. I hope I have time for a nap today. I don't know if I'm going to make it through the day. I like 8 hours of sleep. And when I don't get it, I don't like it. We'll put this over here. Now, our butter has melted. So in here we're going to put, this is one large onion that has been chopped up. And we're going to put this in here. And all we want to do is keep these onions going until it's until they're nice and soft. So And I think what I'll do is, even though you normally leave the lid off to do something like that, put the lid on just to get it to go a little faster. But in the meantime, we'll start to put our avocado salad together. Here I have two avocados that I've already sliced in half and took the pit out. So we're gonna cut those up and put them in. I don't know how you do it, but I always just kind of, you know, put marks in like that, and then, you know, this is how I get my cubes. And some people take it all out of the, you know, the skin and do it that way, but this is kind of my way. So however you want to do it, perfectly fine. This is really a good salad too. Get these broken up a little. Boy, I can feel the onions already in my eyes. I think I told you one of my texts that, I don't know, I have trouble with onions. My eyes really have a hard time with it. So let's get all our avocado in here. You know, if you want to put in three avocados, you could do that too. But this is what I'm doing today, two avocados. Avocados are so good for you. There we go. Mix them all up. Now one more half here. I've got El Diva. I don't know if anybody's familiar with El Diva, but that's what's playing in the background. It's such peaceful music. I should have put on something a little more upbeat. Keep me awake. So there we go. Now here's our avocado. Now what we want to do is we want to put some lime juice on the avocado to keep it. Excuse me. Like I said, anything goes today. I'm pretty damn tired. Let's put some lime juice on here. Keep it from oxidizing and keep it from getting brown. So, just go like this. And that's enough lime juice. And I didn't bring over my spatula, which I wanted, so I'll use this spoon. Get it mixed up. Now, to this avocado, we are going to put in a bunch of stuff. First, I have, my apples were small. Normally I would put one apple, but they were small, so I've cut up two apples here. And do leave the skin on, because as you know, the skin is supplies ursolic acid to your, for your one of your daily nutrients. So keep that skin out, because it's very, very good for you. And then I've got about a half a cup of coconut here. Oh, and I can smell the onions. They're finally doing their job here. Let me give them a mix. Yep, they're doing it. Ooh, actually, they smell really good too. Those smell good. We'll give those a few minutes, and then I'll show you the ingredients that we're going to put in there. But continuing with the salad, if I can reach it, we're going to put in some dates. Again, I have about a half a cup of dates here. And then I have about a half a cup of walnuts. Then I'm putting in. So I'm not going to be pouring the dressing on here. I'm going to be serving the dressing on the side. Because some people might want to eat this just like it is, with just a little lime juice on the avocado. But the dressing is really quite tasty. I'll have to taste it in 1 second here. But we'll dish this up a little bit later when we dish up our soup. So let's put that there. And they're doing good. Just about ready for all the other stuff we're going to put in here. I didn't put any salt and pepper into my dressing. I'm going to put in a little dash of salt. And let me put in a little pepper. I'm so sorry I keep going away from the camera, but that's the way it is today. I want to thank the people who are watching. You know, and I get a lot of nice notes from people. I get a lot of people asking me different things, especially about, you know, my cancer and some of the things that I've done. And I enjoy answering the questions. I enjoy, you know, trying to help anyone that needs help of any sort. So, you know, continue to feel free to email me at donelsorelli@gmail.com. Let's give a taste of this dressing. It's good. It's real good. So, anyway, all right. The onions are done. Now, to these onions, we are going to add 1 16-ounce can of petite tomatoes that, you know, that have been chopped up. I like the petite. Well, I like the medium size too, but for most people who are not big tomato eaters and so forth, you can always hide the tomatoes with the petite sizes versus, you know, the bigger ones. So in here, we have the tomatoes. Now we have 2 8-ounce bottles of clam juice. 1, 2. And then I have 3 cans of chopped clams. That are going in here. They're the small cans. I believe they're 6 ounces. But these are the chopped clams going in. This is, like I said, really good soup. Then we're going to put in some celery. I've got about 3, you know, stalks of celery that I'm putting in. Put that in. Now I've got 1 potato that has been cut up into chunks that I'm putting in. Then we're going to put, I wish you could see this better, but unfortunately, I don't know how to get the camera above and whatever all you have to do something like that. I have 3 bay leaves. I know it sounds like a lot of bay leaf, but 3 bay leaves that I put in here. Then I put in a little bit of oregano, maybe about a 1/2 teaspoon of oregano in here. And then some nice, freshly chopped parsley going in. This says stir. Now, like I said, this is it. This is all you do. I don't know, there's something that always looks nice with the green in there, the parsley. I'm going to put in, I don't know, maybe that's 1 teaspoon of salt. Maybe that's 1.5 teaspoons of salt. Of course, at the end, you're going to taste it to your liking, and then you put in as much pepper, you know, as you'd like. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to put the lid on, and we're going to bring this, I'm going to use that. It's got avocado in it. And we're going to bring this to a boil. After we bring this to a boil, we're then going to simmer for 1 hour. And make sure after that hour you check your, you know, your potatoes. Make sure they're tender. And then we will dish it up. So we have 1 hour. So I'm going to be right back. Come back. Bye-bye. Okay, the camera went off accidentally, so I'm not sure where I left off. I hope it's not broken or anything like that. But anyway, as I was saying, you could put some crunchy things on top of this. You could put some parsley. You could do a number of things that you wanted just to make it look a little, you know, a little better if you wanted to. But it does look yummy like this. I don't know if you can actually see into that, but that's how it looks. So let's scoop up a little bit of salad here too. Now what I like to do is, as I told you earlier, I don't like to put, you know, the dressing onto the salad. I like to have it just to, you know, put on the side, and a person can put it on themselves. I'm just going to scoop a little bit into the bowl like this, or on top of my piece of lettuce, just like this. And doesn't that look good? You know, especially the coconut with the avocado and the dates is really, really a nice mixture. So what I do is I put my salad dressing into this jar, you know, like to shake it up a little bit. And then I would just put it in a little bowl on the, you know, on the side, like so. And then a person can put on what they, you know, what they want. You certainly don't need, you know, don't need much. So, you know, you might want to add a little freshly ground black pepper, especially people who love pepper. I told you in one of my videos, like my mom loved her pepper. So that kind of gives it a little more oomph. And then I like to just stick on top a little decoration. I like to stick in a little bit of mint. Oh, we don't even have to stick it on top. Let's stick it over here. That might be better. Yeah, that looks better just like that. Then I also put a little lime wedge, you know, in case the person just wanted to add a little lime, but that's how I would serve it. So this is the end of January, and this is the end of our soups. I'm going to do a shrimp scampi for you for Valentine's Day. And I think I'm doing that next week. But if there's anything you want to see, let me know. I'm also going to do a healthy dessert for you, just with strawberries. But as you know, my whole intention is everything healthy, everything in moderation, and to be well. So do write me. Like I said earlier, I've heard from a lot of people, and I really enjoy hearing, you know, from you. And I think a lot of people, instead of making comments on my channel, they prefer to write directly, and that's perfectly okay. But again, if you want to write comments, I love hearing the comments, you know, as well, or anything you want to know, you know, feel free to ask, or if anything you want me to do, you know, feel free to ask. So as I always say to you, I always say siate felici, you know, which is to be happy, but I also say to you, be healthy, have a wonderful day, and what else? I don't know, can't think of anything else but to say bye-bye now.